students, let us learn about the commercialization of agriculture. Now, what is commercialization? Commercialization is buying and selling of agriculture means of the crops. Now, crops are divided into two categories. You are learning in the geography also that there are commercial crops or cash crops. The crops that are grown and sold in the market for the industries like tea, coffee, jute, cotton, rubber, etc. During the British rule, it was indigo also. So, when the farmers repeatedly grew these crops in their land, the fertility of the land affected to great extent. And it was basically impossible for the farmers to grow any other crop other than these cash crops in their land. They could not grow any other crop for their own consumption. So the cash crops, they destroyed the fertility of the land. So the farmers, they had to pay the tax, they had to forcibly cultivate these cash crops for the British industries. Basically, it had occurred during the British rule after 1813 in India, so that these cash crops could be used to develop the British industries. But these cash crops destroyed the fertility of the soil and the farmers were no longer able to produce any other crop in their land. So that put the farmers in great misery. They were very much troubled by the cultivation of the cash crops. So commercialization of agriculture means growing of the commercial crops or the cash crops for the benefit of the British industries. Now, it only benefited to the British East India Company and the traders, and to some extent some of the Indian traders also. So middlemen who acted as the middlemen, the traders who acted as the middlemen between the farmers and the British company, they were also benefited by commercialization of the agriculture in India. Now, next we are going to learn about the term deindustrialization. Now, what does deindustrialization mean? The term deindustrialization. Now, deindustrialization, what it is said that before the coming of the European in our country, India was considered as the industrial workshop. Before European traders, India was known as industrial workshop. Okay, because industrial workshop of the world. Now, it was the mixture of the Indian economy was mixture of agriculture and the handicrafts or indigenous industries, the village oriented industries. Okay, now this traditional economic system rapidly declined because of the introduction of different industrial laws by the British. So the decline of the Indian handicraft industry is popularly known as deindustrialization. So the term is opposite to industrialization. Industrialization means development of industries, but deindustrialization means decline in the industry. So because of the British rules and laws introduced in India, the Indian handicraft industry or the indigenous Indian industries were totally destroyed, which is known as deindustrialization. And this deindustrialization it increased in the number of unemployment, then unemployment in turn led to poverty. So the total Indian economy, indigenous economy, had crushed by the British system, British trading system. So the 19th century India had witnessed the loss of industries, Indian industries, which had got the term deindustrialization. So this was deindustrialization, and let us continue with how did the deindustrialization occur in our country.